So what we got over here is mean absolute error okay so what this means is your value of r radius will be this mean or it can be plus or minus this absolute error mean absolute error okay so this will be the range now what we'll do is we will define what is relative error so relative error is nothing but it is the ratio of the absolute mean absolute error and the mean arithmetic mean that we have so this is nothing but relative error okay and once you have this in percentage so if you want to find percentage error what you just do is you take the ratio of mean absolute error with the arithmetic mean and multiply it by 100 this will give you percentage error hope you got this let me take a simple example let us say you have values of radius given as now this is a textbook problem 5.63 5.54 5.44 5.4 and 5.35 so these are all in meters so these are all the readings that is taken next the average is calculated and the average that comes out over here is 5.472 meter once average is received what is done is the difference is taken okay and this mean absolute error is calculated when you put all the values what you will get is you will get the mean absolute error as 0.0904 meter I leave this to you all to verify and when you put it in the ratio form you will get it as 0.017 so whatever is boxed over here is for this value that we have taken and when you put it in percentage what you will have is multiply this with 100 so this will become 1.7% so 1.7% is the error in the reading hope you all understood this let us go ahead and understand if you are measuring multiple things and error happens in combination then what to do how to go ahead let us go ahead with that so we got combinations of error now there are multiple possibilities over here let us take one possibility at a time the first possibility is errors in sum and in difference over here let us take an example if you have measured a and b and they are added to get a quantity which is z now if there is some error in a let us say that error is delta a and there is this error in delta b then there will be some error introduced in delta z now let me write it down over here so your z is equal to a plus b because of this error will now become z may this error can be either positive or negative this will be equal to a again error in a either it will be positive or negative likewise for b okay right so what we can write over here this can be written as a plus b and what is left is plus or minus delta a plus or minus delta b let us compare this with z plus or minus delta z so if you compare this equation and this equation what we have is z equal to a plus b so we'll cancel it out from both the ends so what will be left with is plus or minus delta z is equal to plus or minus delta a plus or minus delta b now over here the z ka what we'll consider is the maximum possible value of z now z ka maximum value will be possible only if a and b are positive So the maximum value will be delta A and delta B. This will be the maximum error. Okay, so we'll take this error into consideration. If it is less, well and good. Okay, what are the other possibilities? You might have minus delta A minus delta B. You might have minus delta A plus delta B, or you might have delta A minus delta B. So the maximum value is given by the fourth option, delta A plus delta B. Likewise, you can write it for difference also. Means you can go for what will happen if you have Z equal to A minus B. You will end up with this equation only. So whenever you have two parameters with some errors, so the resultant error will be addition of the two errors. Okay. Now let us go ahead with the next combination of error. Now in this case, we have error in product or in division. So again, we will take same example, Z equal to A into B. Okay. Or for division, it will be Z equal to A by B. We'll take a simple example of rectangle. What will be area of rectangle? It will be length into breadth. So this example fits over here. So what will happen with delta plus or minus delta Z? So this will be equal to A plus or minus delta A, B plus or minus delta B. Okay. Now over here, what we can do is we can cross multiply. It's not cross multiply. We can just open the brackets and simplify this. What we will get? AB plus A delta B plus or minus. Then we got plus or minus B delta A. And then we got plus or minus delta A delta B. And this is equal to, on the left hand side, we got this Z plus or minus delta Z. Okay. Now what we'll do is we will divide on all the sides. Okay. On both the sides by this. Okay. Okay. So when we divide or in simple words, you can say we will divide left hand side by Z and right hand side by AB, because Z is equal to AB. So it doesn't matter. So when we'll divide left hand side by Z, what we'll have is first term will be 1 plus or minus. This will be delta Z upon Z. On the right hand side, we'll be dividing by AB. Okay. So AB upon AB will give us 1 plus or minus. Now A delta B when divided by AB will give you delta B upon B. A and A will be cancelling out. Similarly, over here you will be left with delta A upon A, because B will be cancelled out from the numerator. And lastly, what we'll be left with? Delta A delta B upon AB. Okay. Now what we can do is we can cancel out this one that we have. Also, this delta A upon A that we got, delta A upon A into delta B upon B. Okay. This is an error. This is an error. When you multiply two errors, it will be very small value, right? It will be a very small value. So we will be neglecting this product. We will be neglecting this product, which is over here. Okay. You can write this term as delta A upon A and delta B upon B. So this will give you a very smaller value. Plus we said that ye 1 1 dono side pe hum cancel kar denge. So what we are left with is delta Z upon Z. This will give us delta A upon A plus delta B upon B. Okay. What this means is once again, there is this plus and minus sign. We took the maximum possible value over here from the previous example that we saw in the last slide. Okay. So this is how it works. Okay. So there is one MCQ based on this. MCQ number 2 in your textbook, you are supposed to solve this. Okay. And that is based on this formula only. So they have said that length may error, breadth may error, how much is the total error. So you can calculate by using this formula. Okay. I hope you all know this delta Z upon Z is nothing but this. If you multiply this by 100, you'll get percentage error. If you keep it like this, this is relative error. And if you try it for division also, you will come to this equation only. Okay. So always remember,